Hey there! In this tutorial, we're looking at how to read and write NSUserDefaults. The code in this tutorial is tested on iOS 9 and Swift 2.0. Anything else, and your mileage may vary. Now, most applications need to store a little bit of data, not enough to require a full-blown database, just a small amount of user data. A really good example for NSUserDefaults is user settings for your app. We can store our name, favorite beer, profile pic in the defaults. Let's take a look and see how we do that.
NSUserDefaults is a user and app specific database. That means we can't read the defaults from another app. It's tied to this one app only. Well, that's partially true. We can create user defaults for a suite of applications, in which case all the apps in the suite can share the defaults. We're using the standard user defaults in this tutorial, so it's just tied to our app. We can't read defaults for other users, of course. That's on their phone. And database is kind of a strong word here. It's more like a dictionary that automatically persists for you. I think of the NSUserDefault as an app-specific bag that we throw things into and we can get them back at a later time. Here's all the different types we can store in NSUserDefaults. As you can see, we can pretty much store anything in here. But that doesn't mean it's a good idea. Don't use this store for sensitive information like passwords and such. Imagine this file is on an open server that any script kiddie could hack into. Sensitive stuff goes into the keychain or an encrypted database. We also don't want to use this for storing large files. It'd be really slow, and there are better storage solutions for that. But if it can be represented as an object, it can go in. So your cat object is good to go. Let's assume we're building an app that stores a profile picture and our favorite beer. We also want to show the user the last time this data's changed. For the profile picture, we'll let the user select any image in the photo album. Any image selection will automatically update the photo stored, and we'll take any text for a favorite beer type and store it when the user presses the Save Beer button. To start, we'll get a reference to the standard user defaults. Let's start with the favorite beer. This example is most straightforward. We'll just call set object with the string we want to store, and the string key we want to use to get it later. Notice we're using a constant for the key. This is a practice we want to make a habit. If we hard code the constants in our code, it's very easy to screw up the case or mistype the string. If we use a constant, the compiler will let us know if we typed it wrong. To get it back out, we call string for key. It's kind of weird that it goes in as an object and back out as a string, especially since strings are structs, but that's where we're at. If we're setting an integer, we'd use setInteger and getInteger. See, it's kind of wonky. So, strings are objects in and strings out. Easy. We also wanted to store an image. We'll use an UI image picker controller to get the image and send it to this method. To save it, we need to get the image data. We'll use the JPEG representation of the selected image and store that. To get it back out, we'll use the method objectForKey. What we get back is NSData, just like what we stored. We'll initialize a UI image with the data and then display it in a UI image view. So that's images in and out. The last thing we wanted to do was save a timestamp of when the user modified the defaults. Dates are NSDate objects, so we use the same objectForKey method we use for the images. This is simpler because we don't need to do anything special with the object before saving. NSUserDefaults knows it's a date. When we pull it back out, we can get it as a date. Once we have the date object, we can use a formatter to display it in any way we want.
And that's how NSUserDefaults works. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. The code for this tutorial is available on GitHub. Here's the address, and I'll include it in the description. If there's Swift topics you'd like covered, again, let me know in the comments. Please subscribe if you like the tutorial. New videos come out every week, and subscribing helps make sure you don't miss any tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.